Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to
Being Friday, let us continue meditating with the Sacred Heart of Jesus, full of compassion, mercy, and forgiveness. And from the side of the Sacred Heart of Jesus came out blood and water, symbols of two great sacraments, Eucharist and Baptism. Let us continue purifying ourselves that we may be worthy of this Eucharistic celebration, and we pray in a special way for the souls of the faithful departed inscribed in the envelopes in front of us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners, Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constance the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven speak to me. Then the voice spoke to me and said, "Go, take the scroll that lies open in the hand of the angel who is standing on the sea and on the land." So I went up to the angel and told him to give me the small scroll. He said to me, "Take and swallow it. It will turn your stomach sour, but in your mouth it will taste as sweet as honey." I took the small scroll from the angel's hand and swallowed it. In my mouth it was like sweet honey, but when I had eaten, my stomach turned sour. Then someone said to me, "You must prophesy again about many peoples, nations, tongues, and kings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorio Psalm. How sweet to my taste is your promise. How sweet to my taste is your promise. In the way of your decrees, I rejoice as much as in all riches. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Yes, your decrees are my delight. They are my counselors. How sweet to my taste is your promise. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces. How sweet to my taste is your promise. How sweet to my palate are your promises, sweeter than honey to my mouth.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
Your decrees are my inheritance forever. The joy of my heart, they are.
How sweet to my
taste is your promise. I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands.
How sweet my taste
is your promise. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My sheep hear my voice of the Lord. I know them, and they follow me.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus entered the temple area and proceeded to drive out those who were selling things, saying to them, "It is written, my house shall be a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves." And every day he was teaching in the temple area. The chief priests, the scribes, and the leaders of the people, meanwhile, were seeking to put him to death, but they could find no way to accomplish their purpose because all the people were hanging on his words. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
The first reading today is very rich and acts like a cornerstone of our Christian life. We hear John had a voice from heaven telling him to take the scroll and eat. And this scroll tasted like honey in the mouth, bitter in the stomach. But at the end of it, of the first reading, the command, "You must prophesy again about many people, nations, tongues, and kings." The scroll we are hearing of in the first reading is the word of God, the good news. It tastes sweet because this good news, the word of God, is the truth. It tastes bitter in the stomach because when we try to live the truth, sometimes we are inflicted, we are refused, we are chosen, we are rejected and killed like martyrs. But at the end of it, we are told, we are encouraged to remain strong, living the truth. There is a saying which says, truth is bitter, but at the end of it, it brings healing, life, and eternal happiness. So we are called today in the first reading to continue eating the word of God. Means we continue living the truth of the gospel of our Christian life, putting God at the center of everything. Even Jesus in the gospel of Matthew chapter 4, verses 4, Luke chapter 4, verses 4, said man cannot live on bread alone, but every word which comes from the mouth of God. Every truth which comes from God is very important for us as Christians. How many people are suffering today because truth is never said, because truth is just being hidden? So in the first reading today, is inviting us as Christians to have that courage, opening the word of God, opening the truth, becoming part of our lives. Let our Christian witness vocation be that vocation of truth and defending the truth. But be courageous and say it with prudent. In the gospel, the same truth which Jesus lived and preached pushed him to do this radical decision, taking a radical position in the gospel of chasing away the people who are abusing the temple, the traders who had made the temple, instead of being the house of prayer, it had become a marketplace, a supermarket like. People, you know, back home when we have a market, open market, there is no truth. Something which is can be sold maybe $5, someone can tell you $9, $80. There is injustice going on. So in the church, Jesus said the church must be a house of prayer. where God takes a priority, the center. Our focus must be always on God. The traders were aiming at making money, wealth. This one teaches us that we as Christian churches should not be only well-built, decorated, but in the churches we must meet God himself. We must meet Jesus himself, who can transform our lives, our attitude, our mentality, so that we become instruments of truth and justice. We too, like Jesus, we are called to remember that ourselves, our bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit. We are the church itself. What is in me that Jesus can come today and chase away? If Jesus could enter here today, can he find me worth of him? Or there is something he can chase, like the way he overturned the tables of even money changers? Therefore, we are called to remember the qualities of a church. One, the church is a house of prayer for children of God. Second, the church must be the house of charity for the poor. The third quality is the church must be a house of purification. The fourth quality is the church must be a house of teaching, teaching the word of God, instructing us how to live our lives. Then the church must be a house of perfection, training us to be saints, training us to be holy people. These are qualities which a church must be having. These are qualities we as Christians, the temple of the Holy Spirit, we must be having. People of prayer, people of charity, people who are ready to purify and change ourselves, perfection, people who are ready to instruct others in ways of God. So let us pray that through this Eucharistic celebration, we might be ready to change our way of looking at the church, purifying our church, and pray that the good Lord, amidst all challenges, may not leave the truth to leave our lips. We be the people of truth, opening the scroll and saying always the truth and living the truth the way John was instructed in the first reading. Placing our trust in God, let us offer him our prayers with one voice. For the bishops of the church and their call to missionary discipleship, may God continue to inspire and strengthen them in their mission. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who hold public office, may God guide them away from corruption and toward the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer from exploitation of any kind, may God console them in their human dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us gathered here, may the Lord increase our faith and commitment to the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, may God welcome them into heavenly kingdom with all the angels and saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our special intentions, we present them to the Lord in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Almighty Father, listen to the prayers we offer this day and answer them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May you accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of Your Majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to You and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hand as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy,
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 Holy, Holy, Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat his bread and drink his cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of their resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and from the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say one word,
and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray.
we have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace, the Mass is ended.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us and help us.